Hi, my name's Samuel Clark from the Spinal Recovery Program and the Movement Studio, and I'm going to talk to you today about anterior pelvic tilt. And if you've been told that this is what's causing your back pain, then it's a really good idea to watch this video to the very end, because there's a good chance it's going to help you understand a little bit more about your back pain recovery journey. And so, anterior pelvic tilt is really traditionally thought to be a big cause of low back pain. And I frequently have patients and clients tell me in my one-to-one clinic that I run for back pain patients, and also in the online support group that we manage as well, that they've been told by their chiropractor or their doctor or their physio or their PT or anyone really that they have an anterior pelvic tilt. And what's more, that it's the main cause of their problems and it needs to be fixed. So here's the thing with this idea. It's really an unhelpful belief. And although it's often spread by well-meaning people, it can sabotage a person's recovery quite drastically. And it's one of the many instances in back pain recovery and in back pain management that we see the emergence of something called the Dunning-Kruger effect. And this is where a person has a small, limited slice of knowledge about a complex subject, in this case, the modern diagnosis and recovery methods for low back pain management and for spinal condition management. And then based on their small slice of knowledge, they overestimate their understanding of the subject as a whole. And it can ultimately mean more confusion, more frustration. It can ultimately result in longer pain and higher pain levels for longer. And it can mean not being able to trust your back again to do what you need it to do for longer as well. And so the idea of this anterior pelvic tilt, this forward tilting pelvis, being a big cause of low back pain really creates this untrue and outdated narrative about recovery. And I should say that for a long time, I made the mistake of focusing on this too. I spent a lot of my time trying to fix my own pelvis position and that of my patients. And it was only once I left this outdated concept and others like it behind that I was able to manage my own pain properly too. And so I'll show you now three reasons why this traditional idea is really not as important as we once thought it was. So firstly, when we take a whole group of people with no back pain and we start measuring their pelvis alignment, a significant portion of these people will measure up to have anterior pelvic tilt. And it means that in both people who have back problems and people who don't have back problems, we see this emerge. And we even see it in high-level athletes as well, including the world-class sprinter Usain Bolt. And to really go deeper on this point, the actual measuring techniques that we use to assess people to figure out if they've got anterior pelvic tilt and to figure out if they have pelvis alignment issues are pretty flawed to begin with. And studies have now been done on the anatomy of the pelvis, and what we see is that the traditional markers, the bony prominences that we use to understand if their pelvis is positioned in a negative way, are in different places for almost everyone. And what this means in reality is that there's no consistent way for us to measure anterior pelvic tilt, because these bone prominences are no longer reliable indicators of pelvis position. Now, the second reason that this needs to be left behind is that really trying to pin just one thing as the main cause of chronic back pain and chronic back issues is a little bit like the metaphor of trying to sail across an ocean on a boat, only with no navigation system and no crew and no engine. You know, you need to know how all of those things relate to each other, and you need to have them all in the first place if you want to make that journey. And for 90% of us with long-term back issues, there are multiple things as well that we need to put in place and that we need to understand in order to take effective action in recovering from pain caused by back issues. And it turns out that pinning our hopes on just one thing and ignoring everything else that matters usually doesn't go very well, because again, we're trying to oversimplify the fact that for the overwhelming majority of us, it requires a little bit more thought and a little bit more expertise than just this superficial understanding of pelvis and pelvis tilting and pelvis alignment. And it really has a tremendously minor influence on your recovery as a whole. And in our online programs that we do with people who have back pain, and we teach them a whole array of different things that help them manage their pain and understand their condition. And we break those into three categories. The first is mindset, and it's really about gaining the right knowledge of your problem and so you actually understand what you can do to help it. And then there's movement. This is specialized spinal rehabilitation that strengthens the back and shows your spine how to move in effective ways so that it gives you less pain and you can move through life and do everything you need to do with it. And the third of those things is mindfulness. And that's brain training exercises underpinned by pain and neuroscience that literally teaches your brain to reprogram the way that it processes your pain and the way that your body processes pain. And so the third reason that we'll look at as to why anterior pelvis tilt is really unhelpful is this. The whole concept and the relationship to pelvis tilting and back pain in the first place was underpinned by outdated science that has long since been shown to be unfounded. And it's just an old, outdated idea that really doesn't have much credibility anymore. It was originally made up by people who, back in the day, just didn't know any better. They were scientists, they were doctors, but they didn't have the type of testing and skills that we have now. And so it's an outdated working theory at best. And for me, that's not really enough as a basis build the advice and build the strategies that I give to someone who's struggling with life-changing back problems. And you know, we're lucky enough to work with people all the time who have been told that they have anterior pelvis tilt. And it's a big part of what we do to safely and respectfully get them moving. And we show them spinal rehabilitation and we teach them where to direct their focus to truly give them independence and control over their body again. But when they stop moving and they stop doing rehabilitation and they go back to their usual life, that pelvis position 100% of the time goes right back to its original state. And that's not a bad thing. Your body has a natural way of working and everybody's body works differently. And so putting a large amount of time and energy into changing the angle of someone's pelvis is something that usually comes up pretty short of the mark. And it's something that we see with almost everyone that we work with is when they understand the how and the why behind their movement. When they understand these things, it helps them in getting better. It helps them recover. And it's not about understanding some imaginary pelvis positioning. It's about understanding how to move, why to move, and in what ways you can move to help your back become stronger and more adaptable. And we find that once people with long-term back problems learn to move the pelvis and learn to move the hips in a pain-free way that broadens the amount of movement their body can tolerate, and it stimulates the muscles and the nerves and the tendons and the ligaments in the right way at the right time for their body, that is what sparks the beginning of a journey from a back that feels pretty fragile to one that can feel amazing. So don't fall into the trap of not seeing the wood through the trees. Long-term recurrent back pain is complex and it's influenced by loads of factors that when addressed in a way that really considers the specific needs and demands of your body can be recovered from. And you know, I'd be selling you seriously short as a health professional if I tried to pin all the issues on one single factor. And then I'd be selling you even shorter if it turned out that that one single factor turned out to be completely irrelevant in the broad scheme of helping you recover. So keep the main thing the main thing. Keep focusing on what will give you the main bulk of your improvement and try and spend less time and energy and attention worrying about things that won't. And if you've been hung up on thinking about anterior pelvis tilt and your back pain, then you know, hopefully this has given you some ideas about its level of importance and its level of hierarchy in your recovery. And hopefully it's set you up to move forward as well. So that's all from me for the moment, and I'll see you again in another video. Wait, don't go just yet. If you found that content useful, then join our brand new Facebook group, Low Back Pain Recovery, and feel free to add me personally on Facebook as well. Again, my name's Samuel Clark, and in the picture, I'll be wearing this t-shirt. And of course, don't forget to like and subscribe to this channel, the Movement Studio Programs. That's all for me. Again, my name's Samuel Clark from the Movement Studio and the Spinal Recovery Program, and enjoy the rest of your day.